Hey guys, what's up? It's Otters here. I know I haven't been posting to my channel really at all since teasing the hype start of Conquest Season 5, but as many folks in the art community know, my time on Conquest was cut unexpectedly short. I'm also a little late to the party when it comes to discussing my tribe being banned and all that would entail, so I wanted to take some time to kind of explain my side of the story and my perspective on the situation. I've played every season of Classic and Conquest, and really, in my opinion, it's one of the best game modes out there. So naturally, when the new season was announced, I was excited to start fresh with some new tribe mates, as well as experience the new unlimited tribe member change. In the past, it was only ever 25-man tribes, so this was a pretty big deal for us. We got a crew together, and the majority of my tribe came from unofficial, mainly MTS, which has a reputation for being one of the most competitive clusters out there. So naturally, we hit the first week of the season pretty hard. Despite my tribe not really being used to large-scale groups, everyone knew what to do. By day 3, about 150 of us all had boss fights done and had the engrams needed to progress. We were also one of the first tribes on the cluster to complete Island Ascension, and so things were looking pretty good for us. But a lot of my tribe mates had explained to me that they never really gave Classic or Conquest a chance due to the rumors of admin abuse and dev corruption, and while things used to be bad in previous seasons, things had also gotten a lot better with the release of the Enforcement Discord after Season 3. So much better, in fact, that I swore to my tribe we'd have a good and clean season. I helped convince a lot of people that the GMs were responsive and extremely helpful through this Discord they had just made. And over the seasons, I had grown to know these 3 members of the enforcement team fairly well due to having to make a large amount of tickets on behalf of my previous tribe, GT7. And looking back on everything now, I feel an incredible sense of guilt. I feel like I was an advocate for these servers, questionable as they were, only to now see it's been a gigantic waste of time for my friends and anyone else in the art community. So let's get into the events that led to my tribe, the Island Boys, being banned. For me, it started like this. I had turned on my Twitch stream as Shockus, Muntage, Heavs, Texas, myself, and several other tribe mates went to server 49 to grief, a server we came to soon realize was T's main server. We attacked a greenhouse of theirs in which we encountered some pretty bizarre quote-unquote server issues. It seemed that every time we gained the advantage on T, the server would drop and roll back. Every time the servers came up, tames previously killed by us were alive and well. And like I said, this happened again, and again, again, and again. And as you can tell by the look on my face during the stream, I was pretty much over it. This repeated about 10 times before we made the group decision to back away and not kill anything. And sure enough, the moment we left, the server was stable again. It's at this point one of our tribe mates got banned for using a fabricated sniper, falsely accused of aimbot, and his appeal got ignored despite him having all the footage he needed for the encounter. Towards the end, we engaged once more, killing a mana garmer, and when suddenly, you guessed it, the server crashed, rolled back, and the mana garmer was fine. So, at this point, we're extremely heated, and within reason. During the encounter, I had reported the issue to a GM who, at the time, was online in the Discord. However, my report went completely ignored, evidence and all. As it was 4 a.m. my time, I had to go to bed, and 7 hours later when I woke up, my ticket hadn't been responded to, and my tribe had decided to fob T's home server, this time with more people. 90 of us, to be exact. And before I could log in to help, everyone was banned. People started submitting appeals into the enforcement Discord, and every single appeal was met with the person getting banned from the Discord itself. There was no server announcement, as only a couple people didn't get banned because they had just joined the server before the bans rolled out. And when we tried to investigate the reason for the bans, well, what we were told was pretty disturbing. Banned for basically reasons that were out of our control. Even I was banned, despite not ever attending the FOB itself, as I was asleep. I made this video in hopes to continue spreading awareness of the blatant dev corruption within Snail Games. I also made this video to apologize to everyone I told this season would be clean and fun. I'm sorry I was wrong, and to be honest, I'm heartbroken over the whole situation. It may seem silly to get emotional over a video game, but we commit a lot of time to the game we love to hate, Ark. So please don't make the same mistake we did. Don't join Conquest or Classic servers. Don't continue to play on them. You're only wasting your time. Thanks so much for listening, and hope to see you guys in the next video.